Hey, welcome back to Science in 10. A quick little recap to begin with. The central tenet behind plate tectonics is that the Earth's lithosphere is broken up into numerous rigid plates that change their configuration over geologic time. But how do we know the plates are actually moving? Let's take a look at a couple pieces of geologic evidence that show the tectonic plates and the continents move around. One of the first people to propose an idea that would eventually become plate tectonics was Alfred Wegener, a German meteorologist and geophysicist. Wegener's hypothesis of continental drift stated that the positions of the continental landmasses were not stable, rather, the continents drifted across the Earth's surface. A main part of Wegener's idea was his evidence that all the modern continents were once joined together into a single supercontinent, Pangaea. Over time, Pangaea broke up and the continents drifted to their current configuration. What evidence did Wegener have? Actually, lots. Here are a couple examples. The outlines of the continental shelves of Africa, Europe, and the Americas matched up on opposite sides of the Atlantic Ocean, almost as if the continents were pieces of an Earth-sized puzzle. Similar rock types and mountain belts on different continents matched up. Distribution of various fossil organisms also matched up across ocean basins. And glacial striations on cratonic rocks in areas that are nowhere near being glaciated at present. And lots more. But when Wegener presented his ideas in the early 20th century, his hypothesis of continental drift and all the evidence was rejected. What Wegener's hypothesis lacked was a good mechanism for what was driving the motion of the continents. As we looked at previously, a combination of ridge push, slab pull, and convection drives plate motion. But we know that now, which gives Wegener's initial hypothesis a lot more oomph. Though, what else could we use to show plate motion? Let's take a look at the mid-ocean ridges a little more closely. We can make a prediction to test plate motion using processes that take place at these ridges. If the mid-ocean ridges are a source of new crust, and as the new crust forms, it pushes the old crust laterally away from the ridge, partially driving plate motion, then the further one gets from the ridge, the older the crust should be. It turns out that is exactly what we see. Here's a map showing the age of the ocean floor around the world. This is all crust produced by seafloor spreading at mid-ocean ridges. Areas where the crust is youngest are red, old crust in green to blue to purple. At every single mid-ocean ridge, the crust is the youngest, and it gets older and older and older the further away from the ridge that you get. The only way for this pattern to form is if the oceanic crust, and hence the lithosphere it is a part of, is moving away from the mid-ocean ridges. So, there we have a couple solid sets of data that are evidence for plate motion. Wegener's observations, and the age of the ocean floor moving away from the mid-ocean ridges. Of course, there are many, many more pieces of evidence for plate motion. Paleomagnetism, hotspot tracks, and GPS measurements, just to name a few. Though, covering all the evidence for plate tectonics will be way more than 10 minutes in length. Future videos? We'll see.